build your dashboard, okay, and that will be available for you. And here is the same thing, okay. If you look at view details, okay, just click on the view details, okay.
1 minute, let me also enable my recording.
Please all enable the recording. Okay, go through that video, okay.
How to start it?
Recording.
And
in bottom, if you find there will be a share screen from where you started sharing screen, just beside that should be a record. Okay, and I believe all are co-hosts, so all can record, okay, their respective.
Remote recording is coming.
So say the local machine, there are two recording, okay.
All right. I think it's started.
So
okay,
we'll get only option once, okay, the person who will start first, okay, for other the alert will not be available, okay.
Okay,
so
yeah,
click on view details.
View detail
in the right hand side pane, right? The two view details, spending rate limit, okay, and there was one more there only, okay. So now this is a graphical. So now you can see where, what resource, what location, okay, resource is getting,
okay,
right, wrong,
okay.
So by reason you can take it, by service name. So if you look at VPN gateway, right, 75 rupees,
yeah,
right? Storage 34,
okay,
virtual machine, so 34.
This is per day?
No, total cost so far, right?
Consumed.
Consumed. So cost, okay, means what is consumed here, okay? So
okay,
if you say that, you can see the cost analysis or cost forecast, okay? So if you click on the, this is an accumulated cost. So if you click on the forecast cost in the same, right, just above 75 rupees, okay, or you can see the bar only, right? So this will become your forecasted cost, okay. So
okay,
that, just click once more. If you look at from June 11 till July 4, which is my billing period, which is light green, is your forecasted cost,
okay,
right? And now say in top there is an a download, okay, if it is a really big report, now you can download the report as well, okay,
okay,
and see where I'm spending more,
okay,
okay. Now like we set an alert, if you wish you can set an alert also, my bill should not go beyond 1,000 rupees, so you will get a notification. We did set this also, just go through that video,
okay, okay.
Download reports, analyze reports, set alert. If you are not getting anything out of it, please let me know, okay?
Okay.
But this is how one person only works for the billing, okay?
So, this is what I have spent. But we cannot, can we see daily how much I am spending? Can you see that?
Okay, so.
Or monthly?
That's what I'm saying, right? So this, just wait here, okay? So just above your cursor, there is an invoice Azure June 5 to July 4th, right? This, just drop down. Now you see what you want to look at.
Last 7 days.
This okay. month, okay?
Okay.
Custom date. If you want to take a custom date for, you can take here, okay? Go back at the, so there are multiple options how you want to check, okay?
Okay, okay, okay.
So this is a period you need to select, and we can only use the feature, whatever features are available, okay? If let's say you want to see the hourly, you cannot get an hourly.
Okay. Achha, okay. One more thing.
Yeah.
You are admin, I am a user. like this na, you are so if I want to see how much I have spent, can there be?
It will not be.
Okay.
It will be. It okay. will be. You create your specific resource, go back.
Like here.
Wait here.
I have created some of the things.
Leave it. So you created everything in the resource group. Okay.
Okay.
So check the cost. Okay. Which is billed against your resource group. Go to subscription once again. Subscription. Click on subscription. Now, view details how you want to see the details, okay? No problem. Okay, so there is another view details also, right? So there are both are there, cost by resource and view details forecast. Click on it. Now, if you see, this is a cost by resource, okay?
Okay.
In the third pane, there is a resource group name. Third, just come down. This, right?
Yeah.
What do you need? Okay. You take your resource group name. Okay. And it will tell you your cost. Okay. So now you take where is your one. Okay. This is max is coming for me only.
Only yours.
No, will be there. It cannot be, right? Because this is a. Mine, I know. So you are not building then anything?
No, if you see my resource group, my...
Go ahead.
What is this then? Virtual machine is there. Oh, I deleted virtual machine now before the class.
Mm.
That's why.
No problem. And so delete other, it then other, also.
Others are free, whatever I have.
Then also there should be 5 rupees, 4 rupees, 10 rupees, something should be there, right?
Acha, if I have I created this virtual machine yesterday night and today morning I deleted it,
so whatever number of hours it will be billed, right?
So here you are saying here, resource by resource
in group. Top also go, let's wait. This is resource okay. group in also in top in just
last
above this.
7 days.
No, so wait. So this is by this, just drop down by resource group, resource group, right? So
resource group
only will tell your thing, right? Okay, so
I don't know.
Click 1 to 11 of 11. Why are resource group? So it's not. So you created today only?
Yesterday night I created.
VM.
Huh.
But then it should be there. There is no point that it will not happen. Okay, let's wait. Okay, then you review it once again. Okay, might be the report for your resources is not done so
see,
far.
Can you see?
Yes, I agree. Right, I agree. See, immediately it cannot tell your bill. Okay, it cannot tell your bill.
Maybe it will take time to
after 24 hours only. Okay,
that's why.
But if you have created anything before, it should be billed here. Okay.
But rest of the things are free. This means.
Free, yeah.
Okay.
Hmm. Okay. Any other question by anyone? Ramesh, Shai Karslan.
Yeah, well, in third session, I think regarding policy, a lot of confusion policy. So okay. I think...
Yes. Go ahead.
So better you can give one more session policy. Okay, at the end.
Yes. So I believe I did mention, right? So once you're, because that is literally an advanced topic. Okay. So once this course is there, then I will implement the policy. Okay. that time you will have the overview of all the services, okay, what we are doing, then it will give you more understanding. Okay.
Okay.
Got my point?
Yeah. Okay, I have done all.
I did mention, live. I believe.
Look fine. Good. So, in custom domain, okay. So,
you went up to the custom domain.
Yeah.
You are running in advance. Okay, good.
No, no, you are given a session for custom domain as well, right?
Is that okay? DNS, okay, in AD, okay.
No,
AD.
No, only brief you have done for custom
domain. Okay, okay, that's what. Okay, then it's good.
So I on domain, so I try to search. I think we don't have any means a privilege for custom domain here, right?
See, I showed you, right? The custom domain, right? I showed you. I will give you, just write down this point, okay? I will give you once more demo for that, okay? And you was asking, so let me share my screen, okay? So let me go ahead. So if you come with the Azure free account, okay? You come with the Azure free account. What are the free availability? Free availability you can look at here. Okay. I sent a link. This is free availability. What is always free is this list. Okay. Prashant and everyone. Will that help you?
Yeah, this is very interesting. Yes.
Yes, for everything, and you should go ahead. It will give you different things, okay? When we say free 12 months, what is free in 12 months, okay? And this also not that you consume everything within a month or something. And what is available free for always, okay? So if I take an example of VNet, virtual network, right? We will never create a virtual network, right? More than 50. In our learning environment. So it becomes always free. Okay. Is that
clear? Yes, yes. This is very helpful.
Yeah. So please use this link. Okay. So any other question, Ramesh?
Yes, sir. One thing.
Yes. So
suppose if you create any Azure AD custom domain. We'll create user, right? With that,
yes. So, that's what we needed, right?
Yeah, that Azure AD, will it be like the user ID, will it be synced with the local AD?
So the way you want to add, right? So if you like Azure Active Directory, okay. Now this is my Active Directory, right, Tom?
Right.
Now, if you add anything, okay, anything, any domain, okay, the domain, why I need, because if I create any user right now, okay, if I create any user right now, how it will go? It will go on my ID, okay?
Right.
But that is not really requirement is. Requirement is what you are saying, okay? So in that case, what will happen? You have a custom domain. That custom domain is listed here, okay?
Right.
Now, you need to select on which domain you want to create an user. If you say that your domain is abc.com, okay? Then if you are creating a user, then you need to select which domain I am creating in. Then it will go into the abc.domain. Okay. It will not go into this.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. And that's how the organizations does work. Okay. Because if this is an account for every user, it will not be a good practice, right? I want to use bhudev.sharma at the rate of unisys.com. Very simple.
So you mean to say, like, suppose the normal AD is also having ABC, and as we have integrated that custom domain in Azure AD, so it will sync up with the local AD and Azure AD, you mean to say?
No, see, as of now, please do not involve the normal AD, okay? Please do not.
Okay.
This is a domain, okay? This is a domain, custom domain, if you remember.
Right.
Which is available in Azure Active Directory only, okay, not the Active Directory, okay, or Microsoft Active Directory.
Okay.
Got my point?
Right.
That comes Okay. If time permits, you are interested, I will show you. That's very interesting. That comes using a AD connect. Okay. AD connect. And once I connect an AD, okay, Microsoft AD, okay, from on-prem, not in Azure, not Azure AD. Okay. That AD I can create in AWS cloud also if connectivity is there on-prem also. Okay. Then this user is currently in a member user. Okay. Member user in my directory, guest user I created for all of you. Okay. Then that will be in a directory user, means it is coming on on-prem directory. Okay. In Microsoft directory. That will be the third type user. Okay. But if I create a new tenant, okay. New tenant, that will be here, will come as an that one, okay. What you are talking about on a custom one, okay. Now, if I say this is my organization, okay, Bhudev Sharma one, what I want to create on a domain ABC. So, how it will go now? It will go abc.onmicrosoft.com, right? ABC becomes my domain, right?
Right.
Now I can add this. I can use it. So I can create a user in this domain also. That is Azure Active Directory. It has nothing to do with the Active Directory. Just remember, keep these two things different. Okay.
Okay.
But if is there anything where you feel you want to use your on-prem directory or Microsoft Active Directory, which is there in your organization, same users here, okay? That you can use it with the help of Azure AD Connect. And all the users, the moment we will connect and sync without creating any user, all the users will be shifted here, synced here, okay?
Okay.
Got my point? So it depends on how we want to use it. Yeah.
Suppose if we create like new user, it will sync up automatically.
It will sync up automatically. Okay. On defined durations, which is available. Okay. We can reduce and increase the time from the default as well. Okay. But it will sync automatically. By default, it happens on the 30 minutes. And even there are multiple features. Okay. That comes totally in the security. If I want, I can change a password in on-prem. I can change a password in here also. Got my point? If let's say this is user my, okay? And this user came from the on-prem. I can reset my password, okay, from here. And that will be synced back to my Active Directory, on-prem Active Directory, okay? Let's say this user is a Ramesh at the rate of oracle.com that I have connected here. You should reset your password here in Azure. It will be reset back to your Oracle as well. Got my point? And oracle.com is an on-prem directory, right? From Microsoft Active Directory.
Right.
So depends what feature, and in that also, three features are there, very important, okay? In that particular topic itself.
Okay.
Okay.
Is it possible to identify that from which end it was created?
Yeah, definitely.
How it will signify?
Okay. Now, you have an ID, right? Wrong.
Right.
Now, this synchronization, you will do from one Active Directory. Okay.
Right.
Why? Because let me put something in this way. Okay. Very good. Trust me, very good point. Very good question and very good topic. Okay. Very, very good. Now, take this is my Azure, okay, and this is my on-prem. Got my point?
Yes.
I'm considering this is my Azure Active Directory, okay, and I'm considering this is my on-prem directory, okay. And here I'm having 100 users, okay.
Okay.
Basic method using Azure AD Connect, I'm connecting it, or you can say doing a configuration or integrating it. Okay. And here I'm only having a 5 user. Okay.
Okay.
Now, once you do a configuration, what is needed once you do this setup? Okay. it needs a domain controller admin credentials for this, okay, and this is an abc.com. okay, got my point?
Yes.
And this is something on microsoft.com, okay, by default.
No, here also I have created custom.
Leave it, no problem, right? So okay, you will do the integration, right? Finally, right. Azure Active Directory, right? Right. Now, this is having a global admin, okay? Now, trust me, the global admin number one of this Azure Active Directory cannot be the global admin of another Azure Active Directory, okay? It cannot be number two. The admin administrator user of abc.com cannot be the administrator of any other domain, right? Is that clear?
Yes.
So when we do an integration, we do, okay, what is my on-prem, okay? Active Directory administrator credentials. So you will provide administrator password and the domain. You may be running five domain, doesn't matter. But from the domain drop down, you are selecting abc.com, right? Wrong. So it is a specified right now. Got my point?
Yes.
Similarly, here you are using a three directory. Okay. But you are saying for this directory, okay, let's say XYZ. Okay. I'm setting my global admin username password. So this is very tightly integrated, right? Too. Got my point?
Sorry, can you repeat, sir?
Okay. So once we connect abc.com from xyz.com, this is an integration between these two directories, right? Wrong.
Right.
Got my point?
Yes.
If we have a 10 instance on a one server database instance, okay, the password is not same for all the, right?
Right.
Only the SID which we used to connect, only that database we will be able to connect, right? Wrong. Because right, we are providing a credential for that purpose only, right? Wrong. So it becomes a very simple identification and user are coming from this, right? Wrong, abc.com. If 100 user is sequence 1 to 10, then all user will come 1 to 100 at the rate of abc.com, right?
Yes.
So now you tell me which domain it coming from. They are coming from abc.com, right? Now.
So you mean to say here in Azure AD, the domain will populate as abc.com?
No, it's not. Domain will not populate. Only the users will sync. That's it.
Okay.
User so, will sync. Once
so ABC domain won't be created in Azure AD?
No. Never.
Suppose if I want to create any user, new user,
you have to create an on-prem. You have to create an on-prem.
Once we sync up with that local AD, we have to create any user on the on-prem one.
On-prem AD, because if you want to create an abc.com, right? Wrong. If you want to create an xyz.com, you will create an Azure. These are two different domain, right? Wrong.
Okay. So suppose after sync up, if we create any abc.com, I thought like once it is sync up, the abc.com domain will created in the Azure AD also.
Not domain. Please remember, not domain at all. Okay. We are just connecting it, okay? For the user sync identities. This we call as an identities, okay? For the identity purpose. Now, this user A can log into the Azure portal, okay? Because user is synced in Azure Active Directory, okay, but doesn't mean it has created a ABC domain here. Okay, trust me, very advanced topic, very advanced topic, and totally with the security. Okay, totally with the security, but very good, very advanced. If you know this thorough, very good. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
And one more question,
sir. Yeah, please.
In actually, I gone through the videos. In one of the video, you have mentioned that we can restrict the user access region wise.
Yes. policy.
But I didn't understand that. I didn't see that further. That just in one of the topics you have mentioned, even we can, I think, in policy video only.
Yes, yes, yes. So look at, right. So let me give an example again. So let's say your presence is there, right, in somewhere. Got my mind? Your presence is somewhere.
Right.
It could be any part of the globe or world, right? Now, your presence is there in a Bangalore. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, you log in to Azure, okay, on to day-to-day basis to for your day-to-day operations.
Right, which is in some other reason.
Right? Could be anywhere, right, Tong? Now, what happens? You are there in India. If I'm not allowing a policy that you should log in from India, okay? Now what happens, person in Europe, okay? Anyway, he get into the credentials, your credentials, okay? And he log in into it. Will he able to log in or not?
If he has my credentials, he can.
Yes.
He will. Okay. But let's say 6 a.m. today, you logged in from Bangalore location. Okay.
Okay.
And 7 a.m. you are logging from the Europe. Is that possible in any way?
It's not.
It's not at all, right, Tom?
Right.
So what policy does, you are logging from the Bangalore location, okay? We say Ramesh do login from the Bangalore location. If there is any other location, please do a extra authentication, okay? Extra authentication. That's how policy comes into the picture. How extra authentication? What happens? Ramesh logged in Bangalore. Anyway, I get into his credentials. I tried logging in from Europe. The moment I will go into the Azure, Azure is intelligent enough, okay? Not Azure, anything. They use underneath the AI and ML, okay? Artificial intelligence and machine learning. They will quickly check, hey, this person has logged in just an hour ago from India. Now this person is logging from the Europe, whereas he cannot travel by any means, okay, with this short duration. So it will tell when the login, can you give me your extra validation? Extra validation, it could be in a question of a text code of your mobile, okay? It could be in any security question, right? If any security question you have set it here, security question, will this user will be able to get it? No, right? Guys,
yes, yes.
No, let's say if my colleague, I'm sharing my username password with colleague, and I then possibility is there to log in. Means,
no, I'm coming that, right? Okay. I'm coming to that. So, same thing. Let's say Ramesh shared this credential with me, right? Wrong. Got my point. I'm in a Europe. Yeah. I'm trying to log in, but still it will say, okay, what is your other method of authentication, Azure will send a text message to Ramesh mobile number, okay? If Ramesh has given me the credentials to log in, Ramesh will message give me a means, text code also.
Message means OTP.
OTP, it could be anything, okay? It could be anything. It could be a mobile call. The way I want to restrict or control my authentication or secure my account, right? So if Ramesh has given, Ramesh will give me a OTP also?
Yes.
Right, wrong?
Yes.
If OTP, if I enter the OTP, then I become Azure will allow me. Okay. Because I have made a third authentication. But trust, this is not the case. And ideally, that is not permitted sharing the credentials. Okay. But anyway, for some reason, if it is needed, that becomes a legitimate user. Now, coming to the first case, I try to log into the Azure. Azure will ask me extra authentication and message will go to the Ramesh. Is Ramesh going to share with me? No, right?
No.
No. So there is a control, right? This user will not be, and hackers try this very same way. Okay. Sometimes you get an MSS. Okay. Sometimes you will not get an MSS based on how you set up. But this user will not be able to log in. Let's say you are traveling from Bangalore to London. Okay. It will take, let's say, 24 hours. Got my point? Now, if this is an only authorized location to log in, even Ramesh travel to London, try to log in, he will not be able to log in because only authorized location is Bangalore, right? Wrong. What he can do is, in place of Bangalore, he can also use London as an authorized location. Is that clear? So once he traveled down to London, he tried to log into the Azure portal, he will be able to log in.
Portal in the sense Azure portal, initial login access you are talking?
Yes, yes, Azure portal, right? We are talking Azure portal access.
Okay. So that authentication in the sense multi-factor authentication, when we enable that, we'll get the mobile.
Yes, SMS. Yes.
Is that the one?
Yes, yeah, yeah. Multi-factor authentication, mail, call, my device. Okay. So we can set anything. Okay. Even login from your specific mobile. Okay.
So it is quite similar to Gmail. If we go to Cyber Cafe and open Gmail, if you have noticed,
yes,
we get some alert that is, yes, that you, something similar.
Yes, 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 yes. Is, are you the right person? Okay, make authenticate. See, multiple times you might have seen in Gmail, and so and so time you user tried to log in from so and so location with your user ID password. Okay. I have received multiple mails. Okay. Whereas I'm in India, I know I have not tried that. So someone has tried on behalf of me. Okay. That's how the Google or Gmail puts a restriction. Okay. So that policy do control. Okay. That policy do control all things. Is that clear, Ramesh?
Yes, sir. Actually, my question is different. Okay. Coming to here, you mentioned policy, right?
Mm-hmm.
Are these policies will be deployed on AD user or else?
The policy, so as we discussed, so policy is having a scope again, okay? So you say AD user, okay? You say in Azure user, okay? You need to log into the Azure portal, right? Wrong.
Right.
User. Now, as user, you say Active Directory user, you say Azure user. You logged into the Azure portal, very simple. Right, wrong?
Right.
Based on you have an access in Azure portal, you will be able to do your operations, right, wrong? Your day-to-day stuff, whatever you are being given the responsibility, right, wrong?
Right.
Now, you write one policy. The policy where you want to apply, okay, on management group, you want to apply on subscription, or you want to apply on resource group. Got my point? That will be the scope of that particular policy. But Azure user or Active Directory user, whoever having a permission or required probably is to create a policy and apply on a specific scope will be able to do the operations. Okay. First, you need to authenticate, right?
Right.
Azure portal. If you are using a Azure CLI, right, wrong, then you should have a required access for the Azure CLI. Then only you can go to the policy, right? So first is an user. Doesn't matter from where you are coming. But if you say Active Directory user, then Active Directory user can only log in once you have an AD connect. Okay, the user are synced with the Azure Active Directory. Before that, you cannot use it.
Sir, one more question here. Yeah. Users area. Here, suppose we have user creation in two areas. One is under AD user, and another one is like once we go to that Azure portal, by default, we are getting users. Sir.
Correct.
So what
no, by default, you are not getting. So by default, you get only the user using which you have signed in. Okay. Using which you have signed in. So if you look at
this no, user. I'm asking user creation, sir.
Okay.
Now you're an AD user, right?
No, I'm in Azure Active Directory.
Yeah,
there is no AD user. Okay.
Right. Here we have that user creation.
Yeah.
Once you go to the home page, we'll have that list of services, right? In that user also is there.
So same, right? So if you are looking, this is an user, right?
Still you are in Azure AD.
I will remain in Azure AD only.
Just go back one. Go to home page.
Okay. Tell me, I will go. See, this is not integrated with Active Directory as of now, please remember. Okay.
Right.
So this is purely in Azure Active Directory. So you go from here, you search from here. Okay. It will go to the same place only. Okay. Go from here.
Out of Azure Active Directory, I saw that user creation.
This is right. So if I say user, new user,
right? Okay,
this user, then create user, invite user. This will be a screen. Okay. If you are having a guest user, then only invite user will come look at here. New guest user. Okay.
Not this navigation, some other navigation. I got that. It is not in that Azure AD. Directly, I got that user creation groups and users are there in that. So I thought like users are different. Azure AD users and Azure users are different.
Please take a screenshot or take where you got that confusion.
Okay.
See, once this is integrated, as I did mention, please remember, okay?
Okay.
It is not integrated with anything. There is no possibility. There is no possibility of any Active Directory here, okay?
Right.
As of now. Once integrated, there will not be Active Directory here. There will be only user synced from the Active Directory.
Okay.
Okay. Is that clear?
Right. Sir.
Yeah.
Now, coming to my actual question.
Okay.
See, actually, what I was asking you that suppose I have created service, spin up the virtual machine, for this reason, but I'm working from India.
Mm-hmm.
So, can we restrict that? The VM access, which is located on US region?
Yes.
That is what you have mentioned in that?
Yes. If you wish, that you can do.
Like the specific region users only can access, which is located on that region only. In that way.
Yes, that's possible.
Okay. How to do that, sir? Is it with the policy only or else do we do it AD?
Two things. Okay. No, let's keep AD separate. AD will only be used for users and groups in Azure Active Directory or in cloud. Just remember that. Okay.
Okay.
We cannot even implement kind of, as I did mention, in Active Directory, we use LDAP. LDAP, we cannot use it here. So there is a limitation. Okay.
Right.
Now, this is an East US, okay? Means the US. This is an India South, okay? Now you are sitting here, right? Wrong.
Yes.
There is a one virtual machine, okay? Two things. One thing I can control here only. One thing I can control here, my resource, number one, will be available in this region only. Okay. If anyone trying to access this resource outside of this region, will be denied. Okay.
Okay.
Got my point. Outside this region will be denied. Denied now two ways. Okay. Now, which way you want to stop the access? Okay. Which way you want to, based on location? Based on IP address? Got my point. Now, if I know the IP scheme, I can allow from that only. I know only the resource should be accessed by this. So anything granting access on this, where is reason is not this, will be denied. So you cannot log in or access the resources in this region. Third option. I can only allow users in this specific region to create the resource. Got my point? So based on your requirement, how you want to control, you can control. Policy is one way. Got my point?
Yes, sir. Hello.
So policy is one way.
It can be used for defense or finance for a country which
it is being used. Okay.
Yeah, they want that no other location should use their virtual machine.
Look at. Okay. So.
Is it also possible through the firewall?
Give me a moment. Okay, so if you look at what it is, this is the same case we are discussing. Okay, what this is, East, West, and West Europe, right? Wrong. And resource was created by one of my team members here, which is not as per the compliance. Okay, so immediately I get an email. Got my point? Because here the control is not put, policy is not put, so user was able to create it. Got it? Coming, you say the IP firewall. Answer is yes. Now, if let me go to the okay. So, if any NSG is there, okay, network security, let me look at. This is my NSC, right? So, all is having an NSC, okay. I will take this Prashant NSC, okay. Now, this is another control, okay. But in this control, because wherever this particular security group is applied, only where the control will be put, right? Wrong. Guys, wherever the security group is associated, only there the rule will force in, right? The control will force in. If I say, okay, anything, now IP address, okay, anywhere from the public, okay, coming to my this IP address, now you provide an IP address of this instance. Okay. To this, provide the IP address of this instance and say deny with the deny rule, it will be denied. But this is on a very lower level. Okay. Means if you are creating a 10 instance, you need to put this particular control on all three instances. If this security group is applied at the instance level, Got my point, guys?
Okay.
Now, take another example here. Same. If I am having a, let's say, 100 instance like this, do you think this is a viable solution which we are implementing by the security group?
No, because it's very difficult.
Very difficult. Obviously, very difficult. So, what should we do is the NSC which we are using, instead we are using on each VM level, use on subnet level. Got my point? Means you make changes in one security group which is applied at subnet level, and rest applied to all the instances, current instances and future instance as well. Got my point? And let it be, it is a 1,000 instance. Simple, you update a one security rule, it will be applied on all the instances. So this becomes another level, right? Don't you think the management becomes quite easy? Guys.
Yes.
Another. See, why you need to put at all? I don't want you to enter into my house. Very simple. So what I will do? I will put on a lock. This is not typical lock. What we from the deletion or read only perspective we will look at means we will apply a policy. Got my point? We will apply a policy. No traffic is allowed outside of the US. Got my point? No one can access, no one can create a resource. Okay. Again, that is a passive one. So if you'll ask me, I will go with the policy and I will say in this case, no one should be allow the resources outside of East US. Okay. Now you even trying to create these resources in West US, it will not allow. Because the policy will validate this. Is that clear?
Yes.
Very good topic. Very, I would say very advanced. But if you can really think from the level you are, really it's a very good. Okay. Very good. Any other question from anyone?
Regarding this virtual net in that topic, so I was trying to create the virtual net. Okay. And I mean also the network security group, but it was not functioning. Yeah. Yeah, it was not functioning. Okay. I mean, you have showed from the remote desktop and we try to, yeah,
if you have any use case, okay, just let me know. Okay, this is security group, right? Wrong.
Yes,
this
yes.
is security group.
Yeah,
okay. Now, this is, let's say, just quick, this is my VNet. Okay, I'm having this subnet. Okay,
okay,
and this subnet will have, let's say, 50 VM. Right now, I can apply my security group on each VM and I can apply security group as subnet level also, right, Ram?
Yes, yes.
Now, you need to look at what kind of, is my this 50 VM are same kind of instance? Got my point? Is same kind of instance? Then go ahead and apply it here. Okay. If this are for different purposes, okay, different purposes, then please go ahead and create an as per requirement. I say, again, this are 5 different kind of instances in this 50, okay? See, it depends how we want to make our administration easy. Means 10 server in each, just take it, okay? Now I will create 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 security group, right? Instead of the 50 security group, I'm just going with the 5 security group. And I will attach instance based on the respective security group. Okay. Second thing. Now, I need to allow my traffic to to these 50 instances. Okay, then this inbound and outbound comes into the picture. I say add. Okay, let's say you want to allow a traffic from where? Google, internet, where you want to allow for everything, you say any, from any IP. Okay, now with this IP you also can connect, I can also connect. Okay, source port range, is there anything? We can define it. Destination, where I want to go it, I want to go in a IP address, means 192.168.1.4. if I say this is going to the specific server, right? Wrong. This is going to a specific server. What is the service you want to use on this IP address? See, you need to tell, right? To open the port. So if I go to the custom, is this HTTP? Is then HTTPS, SSH, MS SQL, or if is having an Oracle? No. Okay. Let's say this is a MS SQL 1433, right? Now, on this machine, by this rule, what port is opened? 1433, and this is for MySQL. Now, if the custom port, let's say this is an Oracle, right? Wrong. In Oracle, you can use 1522 also, right? Wrong. 1550. Then what you will do? You take a custom, okay? And let's say my 1523 is my Oracle port. Got my point? So what port you are allowing it here? This is an 1523 is an a custom Oracle port. Then you need to provide an a priority, and I say my Oracle allow. Is that clear? From 1523 you may not come to know what this port is being used to, but from here you can say Oracle allow. You can say my DB allow. So you should be knowing what this DB allow means, for what port this is being. Now, it's not, you cannot use this. You can use this for MS SQL also. Okay, because this is in a custom port. And you created this. Okay, you created this. Now, this port is allowed. Okay, coming from anywhere, sources any, my destination is specific target means the VM on which my Oracle or SQL database is running. Protocol is TCP only. Okay, protocol is TCP only. And I say, okay, this is my database. I can say from here, okay, this is my DB allow. Okay, now you want to allow one another client to connect onto the same, right? So what you can say, you go ahead and you find that another user is 10.10.1.5. Okay, this person also needs a database access. Okay, sorry, comma. Okay, this person also needs a database access. So you will modify it. Okay, you will modify and you will say save. So currently there are two IP address are allowed to connect to this particular database. Sorry, this is my database. This should come from here, okay? Or if there are two databases coming from anywhere, means you allowed this port to two databases. Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay. Give me one example for any other port or anything. Any given scenario, please don't fear that it will be a wrong question or right question. Just give me any question, okay? Then I will answer here, okay? It will give you a good understanding. Okay, let me give one question here, okay? Now you look at Prashant created this rule, right? Wrong. And this is what? This is coming from internet, right? Wrong. Is that clear?
Okay.
Prashant created this rule, and this is coming for 8080. Okay. Web server. I am taking a web server. It could be other also, but ideally this is a range of web server. I'm taking this web server, and now you got in a report. You got in a report that this particular IP. /24 is trying to infiltrate or send a virus into my network. And this is an usual thing, okay? Or this is a malicious traffic, okay? Or this is trying to do a DDoS attack. Got my point? Now what you will do? And it is trying to do a DDoS on port 8080. Is question and scenario is clear for everyone? Any doubt, please let me know.
So can we modify that rule?
That's what I'm going forward. So is question clear for everyone? And trust me, this is very good, huge case. Okay. And we do not on a daily basis, but weekly basis, monthly basis, we do handle such kind of a activity. Okay. And let's say this is really causing a DDoS attack. Now I will make it very clear. This is causing a DDoS attack. So what you should be doing now, okay? What you should be doing. So look at here, okay? Now this is the entire website. If I say deny, is this going to solve my purpose? My entire website will be down, right? Wrong. No one will be able to connect.
It will deny everyone to...
It will deny everyone because you are taking a traffic from the internet. That is not a solution. Okay. What I will do, I will say add. Okay. Source coming from? Right. This is my source. Right. This is my source, right?
Yes. Nice. Yes.
What I will say, source port could be anything. What is a destination is? Okay. What's a destination? Destination is an IP address, destination is a virtual network, or destination is what? Now, I can take from any. Okay. Any. I say port 80 and I say 330. And I denied, okay. Port 8080 deny, okay. So I created this rule, and if you look at, I said deny, okay.
What we denied, sir, in this one? I didn't.
So port 8080.
That is just only name, right? Where we have defined that 8080 port?
This is there, right? Port 8080.
Okay.
Right? Now, can you tell me, will this traffic will be denied or allowed now?
I think it will allow, because in one which I make it, it is for everyone. So it is allowing everyone. The first... We can put priority also, na?
Now you telling the right thing. Currently, because if you look at the, your priority is high, 310, okay? And my priority is 330. So the traffic will allowed from here, and this will not be applicable, okay? The moment I say this 309, okay. Now traffic from 192.168.0.0/24, okay, will be denied, and rest other traffic will be continue. Is that clear?
Yes.
there is something lower the priority. What is that about?
Just go ahead. Go ahead. Please don't hesitate. Go ahead. Speak something. Let it be wrong. I will correct.
So lower priority will be addressed first, then the higher priority.
Okay. So lower the sequence, higher the priority. Okay. Lower the sequence. This is a priority 309. If you look at the sequence, right, wrong. 309 is a sequence. You can call it a priority. This priority is high comparative to this. So lower the sequence, higher the priority. Okay. So this will work in this way. Now, from this IP address, my traffic is denied. Rest, my web servers or the web connection will continue. Okay. From the internet. Is that clear? Is that clear, guys? Not clear.
Can so, Bhudev, because you are already in live environment, yes, you are working. So, can there be thousands of IP addresses that you have to block?
So, try, I believe. Okay, so let me tell you. You say 1,000, right? Wrong. It doesn't come in 1,000, let's say, from 1 to unique 1,000, okay? Means something is starting from 1, something to 2, something from 10. Ideally, this doesn't come this way, but you get on a multiple IPs. Okay. Try to understand, if you are working from Bangalore location, okay? Guys, let me.
Yeah.
We all are working from Bangalore location, okay? Don't you think Bangalore will having a specific ISP or the set of IP address for the public?
Okay.
You mean to say that for Bangalore, the range will be same?
Okay. If Bangalore range will be same, the range for the South or India will also be in a one pattern.
Yeah. So for example,
simply US will be in a pattern.
Yeah.
Okay. Now look at, we are a group of hackers, right? Wrong.
Yeah.
We are a group of hackers. Now Bhudev is sending a 10,000 of packet from 192.168.1.10. 10,000 packets, okay? 192.168.10.22. Prashant is again sending an 20,000 packets. Because we are a group of people doing some will activity, right? Wrong. Evil activity. Similarly, Arslan is doing, Psych is doing, and Ramesh is doing. Got my point? Don't you think this 192 is coming into the same? Don't you think this? This is in a Bangalore IP, okay? In that case. Please do not treat example saying everyone is getting a 192.68 if we are taking it from internet. But your modem is having a different IP, trust me, okay? Outside, only your modem IP will publish, okay? Let it be a static or a dynamic, doesn't matter. And I know my 1 lakhs of unnecessary requests are coming to my server. I need to stop. What I will say, 192.168.0.0/16, I will stop straight away. Is that clear? This will cover 65,535 IP. Prashant.
Bhudev, but if you and me are hacker, but Arslan is a normal user.
Mm-hmm. First, then... you are right. First, I need to reduce my loss, right? Wrong. Do you get me?
Okay.
We need to eliminate the damage first.
Okay, we will make two rules in which one is for
go ahead
for blocking all this range and other is, can we do that?
Yes.
Okay.
Now let's say Arslan I, so only Arslan is a right vector. Okay, rest all are a good bad vector. Got my point? So good vector and bad vector always comes. And Arslan IP is 192.168.10.200. Once I apply this, this is also, Arslan is also blocked, right? Wrong? Is that clear?
Yes, yes.
What I will do, I know Arslan is a good vector. Add. Okay. Source is coming from?
Yeah.
Okay. Destination, you make, okay, any custom allow. So you tell me with this sequence, I say 308. Okay. Okay. What will happen? Using this particular rule, Arslan is allowed, right?
Yeah.
And Arslan single IP is allowed. Rest all are blocked from that range, right? Wrong?
Yes.
And this priority decides whether allow or deny. I have a same kind of a rule, right? Make sense?
Yes, yes.
That way we, I have a requirement, okay? I have a requirement for very much the same you are asking, okay? This requirement speaks the same only, okay? Getting me? This requirement is same, okay? It's not something DDoS attack, but we have to create some specific entries into the security group. That is how the requirements do come in. So this becomes, for me, is a kind of a day-to-day job. Got my point?
Okay.
Because this is something very restricted environment, okay? Any other question related to this? Or any doubt, please do not keep pending, okay? Now you got 1 week. So you should have a good number of questions.
So my question was, so here you have put IP address for Arslan. Okay, 200. Let's say we have 200 people like Arslan who are genuine user for that region. So here we can put after every comma, we can use all.
Yes, those IP separate. Similar like destination, right? Here.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. And how we did, how I typically write. So if you look at, this is all IP, right? And these are real IPs if you look at. This is all security groups, okay?
Okay.
So if you look at, that is how, depends how I'm designing, got my point? There is no hard. See, if for this reason, if I need to allow entire 251 IP addresses, and if I keep writing 1, 2, 3, 4, it's not a right approach, okay? So what I say this will go for with the entire subnet. Okay. If you look at for this IP, I have restricted with /27, right? Wrong. And here you will find all sort of range. Okay. Now, somewhere, let me go. even larger range. Okay, this is a larger, means this allows 1,000 computers. Okay, but this provides a restriction as well. Okay, if anything comes beyond this, he will not be allowed. Got my point?
Yes.
But if you look at these, if you calculate, will be many thousands computers are allowed, many thousands, because I cannot calculate and even I cannot, but it's a calculatable. Keep adding, okay, 251, keep adding 32, keep adding 251, but that's not the right way, right, wrong. And if you look at, this is a specific IP, so we'll allow from the specific IP. Okay. Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay.
Bhudev, regarding the source, so I'm a bit confused there. When
tell me.
So source means what here? I mean,
okay.
Any right. Or?
No, never. Okay, sure. Now, tell me two things, okay? Then I will correlate. This is in a Bangalore, okay? Is that clear? And this is in a Delhi. You want to travel to Delhi from Bangalore. What will be source? What will be target?
Okay.
Very simple.
Yeah.
Is that clear? Now, this is your cloud, okay? Now forget Delhi here, okay? This is your cloud. And in cloud, this is your server, okay? Now, this is you coming from any part of the world. So what is your target? You tell me now. You want to connect to this machine?
Okay.
Is that clear? Now this could be on port 3389. Simple example I am taking. This could be on port 22, right? This could be port 1521. This could be 1433. And this could be port on 80 as well, right? Is that clear?
Okay.
See, the way you can connect using port 80, you cannot connect same way using port 3389, right? Wrong. There is a way for it because these all are for the different purposes. But anyway, these are the connections only, right? Wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you want to connect from the three as an RDP, let's say. Okay, I will say the RDP. So your source is from where you are connecting, right? Wrong.
Okay.
Let's say your IP is 10.0.0.10. Okay. So, and this is what? This is what? Target, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's say this is 23.10.1.5. So basically, your simple target is from 10.0.0.10. You want to connect to 23.10.1.5. Is that clear?
Yes.
Now, if I say here, where you need to allow the traffic, you tell me now first. Where you need to allow the traffic, where you need to apply the security. Come on.
Yeah, between these two IPs only, source and target.
Okay, so let me put one other example, then you answer this question, okay? This is my apartment, okay? This is my apartment and this is my flat. Right, wrong? This is my flat. Now, where you will apply the security? You will apply the security in apartment, my security is there. You will put a lock here, right? Wrong.
Yes.
I believe there are only two entry points, right? Wrong.
Yes.
If your security is not allowing someone to come inside, even your this person, this security allows, will that person will be allowed to come inside?
So you mean to say that on cloud only that we will put that
NSG. Yeah, so see, you never seen, right? This is completely in cloud, right? Wrong.
Correct.
This is not, see, source we are just defining from where we are coming, right? Wrong.
Okay.
To put a control. Now, why? If people is traveling from France is not allowed to enter in India, what does it mean? Reason, because we just put a restriction on source, right? Wrong.
Yes.
But where we have put? We have put in India, right? People from Pakistan is not allowed to come into the India. Where we put a restriction? In India, right? Wrong.
Yes.
So we will put all the rules, NSG. Now, treat this, when I say this is my apartment security, is in a subnet, okay? And treat this lock, my flat door, is my
AIP.
VM label NSC, okay? There are two types, right? We can apply on subnet level, we can apply on
VM level.
VM label, make it very clear. My VM label is my flat, and my subnet level is my apartment entry, right? Wrong. Now we need to put restriction here or both places, right? Wrong. If we put a restriction here, will that mean this will be applied here? No. I need to apply security at my end, right? Wrong. So the simple exams comes, what is my source? Is source is this IP, right? So I will create this way only. Okay. So what is my source? Source is not any now, right? Wrong.
Yeah.
This is an IP. And this IP is 10.0.0.10. Okay. What is destination is? IP. 192.168.1.20. Okay. Or whatever was 20.23.10.1.5.20, same I will write. 23.10.1.5. What port he will come? 3389? Guys? Right?
This 3389 is for
RDP.
RDP, right?
Fixed RDP port, okay? And I say, let's say 250, okay? I will say RDP for my bill. Okay. What does it mean? If you look at, I have put a control only from this particular IP, only from this particular IP. The traffic is allowed to this particular destination. Okay. Only to this destination, the 3389 is allowed. Got? Now I will correlate with this. Now if someone is coming to my flat, then he will be allowed to this particular address only, right? Wrong. We now, can sorry
now modify this to on the whole cloud the yes. same rule.
Yes, you can. Now if no, you want for some reason to come from anywhere, say any, right? Is that clear? And save it. Now, this allowed from anywhere. Is that clear? Not clear? Doubt? Please ask me questions.
Yes, okay. Yes. So, let's say, One IP address I want to restrict to whole cloud.
Correct. Give me that IP.
Let's say the...
You speak anything. Okay. So now look at IP. Okay. Give me... You speak any IP. Don't worry. Okay.
10.1.1.2.
Okay. And this will be a legal IP. Trust me, if it is coming from the on-site, because there we can use the 2 IP. But cloud, this is not the right IP, because in cloud, IP start from 4, right? First 4 IPs are reserved, 0 to 3, okay? Now, what port you want to block? Prashant?
Sorry?
What port you want to block? What access you want to block?
RDP.
RDP 3389. I say deny.
Yeah.
Now, what priority you will give here? Tell me.
So, less than 250.
Yes, always.
Okay.
Deny. Bhudev. Okay. Because you are denying for, see, this could be anything, okay, which you can understand, or anyone can understand by looking at why this boost, this IP is being blocked. So what does it mean? Now means only the Bhudev IP is blocked. And trust me, people don't understand this even doing a expert level of certifications also, okay?
Bhudev, regarding the priority, how do we make that priority selection? I mean, are we giving any number or...
See, just, you can give any number, but there are two logic very straightforward, okay? And very important. Look at one scenario, right, Tom? This is just Prashant gave an example, right, wrong?
Okay.
Now, the previous rule, what I look at, the RDP is allowed from anywhere, right? Source, any. Any includes this IP also, right, wrong?
Sorry, I come again.
Okay. So, what is a source? This source is any, right? Any means 0.0.0.0/0 means everywhere, everything, any IP. Got my point? Am I audible?
Yes.
So any means every, from everywhere it is allowed, right? From RDP. Right? And this any also include this IP address, right? Because any, this is a one IP. This any includes this IP address also, right? Wrong. In current scenario, this will be denied. Okay. But look at, I will modify it and then I will explain. Okay. I say this is, okay. Now, what will be the...
So the priority... Yeah, so the priority changes and the first priority will be 250. So 250 means it will welcome all IPs.
It
So it is welcoming all IPs. 260 says it is restricting one Bhudev's IP.
Correct. But this IP is part of this IP, right? Wrong. Any includes this IP also, right? Wrong.
Yes.
But
yes,
this IP will get entry using this rule. So this rule, if you ask me, is waste right here. This will not be in effect. Because we should understand always what is our scope is. So CIDR is, source is, destination is, IP address is. Now, this traffic will not be. And if someone says, okay, I put on firewall entry, but I don't know what is happening. Traffic is still getting allowed or denied, vice versa. Okay. Now, because this is playing in a role, and the moment I go ahead and change it back to, let's say, 249, okay, anything below
250.
Now, this person immediately will be blocked.
Blocked.
So, we should understand only creating an entry for allow or deny is not important. What I say is not important. Okay.
Giving priority is more important.
Priority is far beyond important. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If I will give you one more example. Okay. And you need to answer. Okay. You need to answer and you need to share your standard. Now I want to 192.168.1.200. Is that clear? Guys, I want to block port 8080. What IP? This. So what this becomes?
Source,
right? What port I want to block?
8080.
Now please tell me what entry with what sequence should I create so that my traffic get blocked.
So we should make an entry with less than 249 priority. So
no
in 309, let's can we edit 309, because 309 already we have deny.
Yeah, 8080, right?
So this is already you have. Okay, so
this may we can add that IP.
You identified one thing, but you are moving in the another wrong direction. Okay, so let's catch it. 192.168. Sorry. What was the IP I gave? 1.200, right?
Yeah.
1.200. I want to block this. Okay.
Sir, the mentioned IP won't come under the first IP range. We have defined /24, right?
You catch the thing, but you just see what you mentioned, okay? So you catch the right thing. If my this IP, okay, if comes in this range, then we need not to allow it, okay, or it won't allow you.
Already it is in that
range. Correct. Yeah, range. So Prashant, you identified very perfectly what ideally we should be doing, okay?
Yeah.
But apart from this particular IP is not the same CIDR block, okay? Because this is having 0.120.255. This starts from 1. Okay. This is a different subnet. Okay.
Oh.
Now, look. I will take another example now. Okay. Now, let's say this is my 0. Is that clear? 192.168.0.200. I want to do the same stuff.
So already.
So we can just remove this entry. Yeah.
Let's say this is my next requirement. Okay, what is this? What it will say here?
Already setting is there.
Already setting is there. So you no should need. Understand what is
no need to be. Do anything.
No need to do anything. Okay, if someone is asking, literally no need to do anything. Is that clear? Guys?
Yes, yes, Pudev. Is quite interesting.
No. Yeah. I mean, I'm not clear.
Okay.
Where is that already setting error?
Hope you can read the subnet 192.168.0.0/24 is this IP. Okay.
Mm. Okay. Overlaps the subnet.
Overlaps the subnet 192.68.0.200. This IP is part of this. If you say 0.200 here, okay. Mm. 0.120.255. This comes IP in between them, right? Wrong.
Yeah.
So it overlaps, right? Wrong. Mm. So there is no action is needed. Got my point?
Yeah.
Because it's already being blocked. Now, correct. My question is not this. I will again reframe my question. Okay. My question is this. I need to allow this. Is that clear, guys?
Okay, now you want
what to, I need to do?
We need to add one rule here.
Tell me where I need to add that
rule. And that should be before, no, after.
Now, I think
before priority should be lower.
Priority should be lower than the deny policy.
Which one is rule? That?
308.
308 is allow.
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
It should be less than 309.
It should be 309. It should be 309. Very perfect. 308 we are already using. So we
307.
We can go with the 307. Very perfect. Okay. So what it says?
Allow IP address.
What IP address I want to use? What port I want to use?
Sir, why don't we use that 308, sir?
It's already there, right?
Can't we add it?
Yes. Yes. Right. Okay. So if you look at, if you already having one IP, right? One rule for same port. So you should not be going with the another rule, and you should say here, this is the best practices.
Yeah.
Is that clear?
But if I create one 307 and same rule, it will also allow me.
Yeah, it will also allow. But better you use this feature, right?
Better to use for one rule, one specific rule, priority only.
One priority, one specific. If this is a port allow, let's allow this way. Keep adding the IP address.
Yeah.
If tomorrow someone asks me 201, okay? This 201. 198.168.10.201. Got my point?
Just edit and add it here.
What I will do, I will say /31. That's it.
Oh, yeah.
Got my point?
Yes.
So how effectively you can use it, because you are an admin, right? Wrong. That you need to decide it. See, it will not trust me, stop me. Okay. Now let me go this way. Okay. First. Take this. It will not stop me, right? But is this the good way? For me, I will choose this way. Now you look at. Again, immediately come overlap?
Yes, yes.
Because this is in a duplicate. So cloud, once you will understand, is very easy to work. Okay. And it's not 50% tough what we have an Oracle. Okay. But yeah, you need to understand what I need to do. That's it. So now I say save and my thing is done.
So in ideal case, in real scenario, Bhudev, this list is very long priority list, or it's a very
not really. Rules hai bas. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
That's it.
Not much rule. Really. Okay. Because most of the things being customized in all the rules. Okay. See, on same server, probably you will not be running Oracle database and SQL, right? Wrong.
True, true. Yes.
Second thing. On the same servers, okay. On the same server, you will be running 5 databases, right? You will be using 5 different ports also.
Yeah.
So the port can be allowed, okay, on same range, right? Wrong. I can allow 8080.
Okay, comma.
8081. I can allow 8088. Comma. Okay, sorry. Right? So, see, I meshed all the 5 database requirement here only, right? Wrong.
Yes.
So, it becomes very easy. The more standard formulated you can use it, the easy it becomes for the administration.
Yes.
Okay. And trust me, this is just, I put an example. We never take in this range. Okay. Like a 309. We take 310, 320, 330, 340, 3 straight away like this. We are not taking as an odd, even between the some greater limit. Okay.
Okay.
You give me any example use case which you are understanding, I will create the same firewall rule here. Okay. To design,
you mentioned that the NSG will work like in screenshot that paint, it will be work as a subnet level and VM level we create separate NSG, right?
Correct. So it depends. So always I discussed scope, right? Right. Whether NSG you want to attach subnet level or you want to add VM label. See, one NSG, okay, can be applied to multiple instances, multiple subnets, okay? But scope changes, right? Wrong?
Yes.
If there is a entry of my apartment, the scope means that entry is applicable to all the apartments, right? Wrong.
Yes.
If entry is to my flat only, that is restricted to my flat, can I access another flat using my entry of my flat? No, this is a dedicated, right? Single door entry. So depends.
So what you mean to say like VM level dedicated and subnet level common global NSG?
No, not common. I'm not using. If you want to use, you can use subnet level also. You want to use VM level also. You can use both level also. It's up to you how you want to use it. Got my point?
Yeah, generally in real-time environment, how it will be?
So depends. So, okay. So let's say. Okay, I will put this way. I gave that 50 server example, right? Wrong, today only. Now, if I am having a 50 server, web server, okay? And this 50 can go up and down to 200 based on the requirement, okay? And this typical use case is Amazon is putting something on sale. Got my point? I'm taking a wrong example, Amazon, because I should use the AWS. But Amazon is putting some example on sale. So do you have any limit how much the traffic could be? No, right? My instances, as I mentioned, going 200. But this 200 are going within a same subnet. Got my point? In this case, if my CQT group is applied, okay, at the subnet level, so all the subsequent instance which get placed in this subnet will get controlled by this CQT group, right? Are you okay with me?
No, I didn't get you, sir.
Okay. Let's say, okay, now we are passing through the COVID, right, wrong, lockdown. Is that correct?
Yes.
Every apartment is having a lockdown. Is that correct? Every city is having a lockdown. Every colony is having a lockdown with government guidelines. Is that correct?
Right.
Okay. As per guidelines, the time is after 10 a.m., nothing will open. Is that clear? So that becomes a one control, right? Is that clear? Here is my apartment. Okay. Here is my apartment. In my apartment, 250 flats are there. And this is my flat. Please try to understand. Right, wrong. Now, apartment authority has banned entry for anyone coming outside. Right? So where this restriction has been put? Can you tell me this?
Main gate,
right? Or my CQT, right? Means this is my CQT, right?
Yeah.
Because the entry gate of my apartment will not be open if some guest is coming from outside. So where I have stopped? At CQT?
At subnet level.
At subnet. Does it only applicable to me, or this is applicable to all the flats in this apartment?
All IPs in that subnet.
All IPs in that subnet. Okay. Now, lockdown is getting open on Monday, let's say. Right, wrong? Is this gate is open to all the flats or not? This is open to all the flats, right? The lockdown is open.
Yes, yes.
But I have put a restriction. I'm not allowing any guest to come in my flat for another 1 week. Is that possible or not possible? Is that right?
It is possible. So
this is my particular, right? My
particular IP.
So this becomes a VM label, right? So VM label applies to a specific VM. And subnet level applies to all the resource, all the IPs in that subnet, right, wrong? Is clear, confusing? Tell me, Ramesh, okay? I will take another example otherwise. Hello?
Yes, it is clear, sir.
It's clear, right?
Yes.
If not discussed, let me put one more way. Okay. So one more way. Now, the same example analogy I have already explained. Now you are coming from web server. Okay. Website. This is my typical CQT group. Okay. Now this CQT group is one here. And I'm using my instance label also. Okay. Now this says port 80 is allowed. And this says port 80 is denied. What will be the outcome of the port 80? Deny only? Guys.
One is saying allow is
denied. This subnet label says, okay, port 80 is allowed. and this is my security group of this VM. This is put, it is deny, okay? Where the traffic is there. From any IP, anywhere you can consider. So what will be the outcome of it? It will be deny only, right? It will not provide a service.
For that particular,
Now, another use case, this port 80 from here to here in subnet label is deny. And here is allowed. What will be the case here?
Fail, deny only.
Perfect, right? So if here is a deny or here is a deny, doesn't matter, you have allowed vice versa. Right, wrong?
Got it. Good.
This is how we should define an NSC. Okay. Any other question?
Sir, we haven't come up to that topic, but simply
no,
just
this topic is covered. You already covered.
Which I'm going to ask that one.
Okay, please ask.
Here you mentioned web, right? So, is there any difference between gateway and subnet NSG?
NSG? Tell me the gateway, in which reference you are referring, which gateway, then I will explain.
I think there are gateways, right, to connect,
yes.
Like
yes,
in Azure also,
yes,
to connect on-premises, so, sites, you have mentioned two
gateways. Correct. So virtual private gateway, okay?
VPN gateway and virtual private gateway, both are same or else?
Same, okay. VPN gateway, okay? These all are, the resources are virtual, okay? So this is an virtual private gateway is an AWS term, VPN gateway is an Azure term, okay? Now, you have a door. One thing is a door. Please try to understand. Okay. Let me erase it and take it fresh. Okay. Just stop me if I'm deviating from your question. Okay. Two things, right? Wrong. This is internet, right? In normal life. If someone wants to come to your house or you want to enter into your house, you need a mandatory door or gate. Is that correct?
Yes.
Means anyone can come only once you have a door. If there is no door, no one can get inside. Right, wrong? Is that correct or not?
Right.
This becomes a gateway. From where we can go outside or come inside is a gateway. Okay. Now, security group is a control over here. Okay. Now, if I want to put a lock, okay, I want to put a CCTV, what these are? These all are the security control. Okay. If we talk about a traffic in computer, means is nothing but coming from as a port. Right, wrong? Getting? Now, if I want to allow or deny, so gateway is another service. Security group, network security group is another service. Gateway is required to connect. Okay. Security group is to allow, okay, or deny. You have username, okay, and password. And you have an authorization, right? So this becomes an authentication. This becomes an authorization. So this becomes an authentication. This becomes an authorization. Security group. Ramesh.
Okay, sir.
Is that?
So you mean to say gateway works as like only author, authentication.
Yes, authentication. Yeah, username and password.
So it will validate whether the user is valid or not.
That becomes authorization.
Okay.
See, two things. Let me put. See, if my apartment is having a door, that is a gateway, right? Gate.
Yes.
Okay. But is allowed or not allowed inside that gate is a different thing, right? Wrong.
Right.
So this gateway is meant if I'm ready to allow, but there is no entry point, then what we will do? Will that be allowed?
No.
No, right? So gateway is mandatory to have a connectivity. But in that gate also, whether is allow or deny is a different thing, right? Two different aspect. I'm having a username password is not the surety that I will be able to access my table. Is that correct? Table means I'm referring in Oracle terms, okay? If I'm having a username and password, will I be able to select something from Scott.emp?
No.
Because Scott.emp is coming here, security group. Username and password is just coming for your gateway. That's it. Username is password only gateway to login, right? Wrong.
Okay.
But you have an access authorization, right? That is comes for your security group, right? Wrong.
We are discussing about VNet and subnet. Okay, so gateway will be at a VNet level or subnet level?
Gateway will be on a VNet level, okay?
Okay,
and this gateway is like we are talking any gateway, VPN gateway, okay? But this is because endpoint, if you are referring, endpoint is not in a gateway, but endpoint is a connection point again, okay, for the specific resource or service. This you can have on a subnet level, okay? Specific for a specific service. Okay. Any other question from anyone? I believe today's session is informative and more understanding, right?
Yes.
This is a benefit of your past week. Okay.
Yeah.
Yes. No, it's needed. Otherwise, no point of going ahead in the course. Okay. If not understanding the things. So are we good now? Or any question, please keep asking question. Don't hesitate. Okay. We are here to. I believe Arslan is so silent, is not asking any question.
No. I will definitely ask
if when
anything is there.
Tomorrow or next week?
Next week.
Please ask. Okay. Please ask. See, now, Arslan, you can understand how much important this discussion is. Okay, probably this discussion you might have not get that much clarity by having four sessions. Okay,
yes.
I'm not telling apart from this, but on a specific topic, now you might have some comfort level. Until unless you will not ask me, it will be very difficult for me to get into because I will not understand what you are not understanding. Okay. So please keep asking questions. Okay. So guys, any other question before we go ahead, or we can take a break, whatever your wish, I'm okay with that. Okay. Either we can take a 10 minutes of quick break.
Yes.
Then we'll go with the Azure firewall.
Paid. Yeah. How many network sessions you are going to
quit? I believe network, there will be two more in this chapter. There are